Hello, I'm Mr. Harmandir, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. And even in the New Testament, you know, the Jewish people, they made corruptions. And with the Holy Spirit, which is common sense, you can rectify them. So gospel you receive by the grace of our supernatural Father, and not by reading the Bible or anything. They are scripture. Scripture are, you can change it. People can change it, as in the passage, you know, that when you go on preaching to, don't take any money, no two shoes, no two tunic. And they change the scripture to sex. Sex means something to carry. Whereas it says scripture, scripture are letters. And our covenant with Jesus or with God is of the Holy Spirit and not of the letters. Holy Spirit is oral Torah. His word it will bring. So here I'm doing exposition of John, which is very important, John 8, verse 31 to 42. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., delivered by the First Anointed Christ, which in Punjabi we call Satguru Jesus, according to St. John 8, verse 31 to 42. Jesus said to those Jews, inwardly, faithful to Abraham and to Yahweh. In the Bible says, those who believed in him, and those who believed in him, they should be Jew inwardly and not outwardly. Faithful to Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda, etc. Who believed in him? That is wrong, as you can see later on. If they believed in him, they were baptized by John the Baptist in the name of Abraham. So they should be the sort of Abraham. But as you can see later on, they are not. If you remain in my word, you will truly be my brethren and not the once-born spiritually blind disciples of the rabbis learning the scripture. The transgression against the moral law is sin. So, Luke 16, verse 16, law and prophets were till John the Baptist. And after that, you know, Holy Spirit enters, which rests in your heart. And if you speak something not what your heart says, not right, then you commit blasphemy, telling lies from your heart. As Ananias and Sapphira did, that they sold their possession and they kept back money. And they knew it, colluded with each other. So that is what blasphemy, and that's why Peter killed both of them. So learning the scripture, and you will know the gospel truth. And the truth will set you free of the dead letters called scriptures. They answered him, we are descendants of Abraham and have never been enslaved to anyone. How can you say you will become free? So you can see, you know, they are not the one who were twice born, they were once born. These Jews were not those baptized by John the Baptist, but Jews outwardly, the stooges of the temple priest, of appearances, unfaithful to Abraham and to Yahweh. Otherwise, they will know what freedom in Elohim is. They should know, otherwise they doesn't know that. Now, Jesus was the son of Yahweh, and Christ in him, that was the son of the Most High Elohim. And here it is. What is it? Jesus was son of Yahweh. This is the, these parts are made by Yahweh. Three here, three here. The soul comes from the Elohim. And they are lit by this light. Middle candle light. Middle candle is of Elohim, which is the oral source of oral Torah. And that was missing among the Jewish rabbis and Jewish people. Samaritan were having the light of oral Torah. And they were perfect. They did not need gospel. As the leper who was cured of leprosy, he wanted to join Jesus to listen to his sermons. But Jesus said, no, no, you go home. You don't need it. So Samaritans were spiritual. And the Samaritan woman at well questioned Jesus in Holy Spirit and found him to be a prophet. And then he said, when Christ comes, he will tell us everything. She knew that Christ is greater than prophets. Prophets are whip master for the rabbis. Moses, John the Baptist, was prophet Elijah. And so Christ is middle candle, son of the Most High. And so this is the difference. And this is a Christianity in a nutshell. So 12 laborers of Jesus had nothing to do with the 12 tribes. 7 were in the name of John the Baptist and 5 in the name of Christ, Jesus of heart. So this is the kingdom of heaven that you see in a law and order outside. This is the royal kingdom of God, which is of heart. So Christianity is of heart and not of the dead scriptures. This is my book. You can find it on Google. So with this introduction, all you will know what I'm talking about. So these Jews were not those baptized by John the Baptist, but you outwardly of appearances, unfaithful to Abraham and to Yahweh. Otherwise they will know what freedom in Elohim is. They took the literal sense as they did not, as they were not the twice born of Holy Spirit, which is common sense. Jesus answered them, Amen, Amen, I say to you, everyone who commits sin is a slave of sins. Sins are transgression against the moral laws. So that's why Jesus said, when you go preaching to, don't take any script with you. Script means Bible is forbidden. And these people thump Bible full of corruptions. A slave does not remain in a household forever, but a son always remains. Now remember that Hagar was a slave woman, and she was in the household of Abraham. But as soon as Isaac was born, then the slave woman and her son Ishmael were taken out of the boundaries of the promised land and made to settle there. He did not throw them away. He settled them. So, same way, you know, the transgression against the moral law is sin, which is letters. And we are not under letters anymore. We are under Holy Spirit. So we are no more under sin, but under blasphemy, which is more serious. A slave does not remain in the household forever, But the son always remained as Isaac, you know, remained, and so the Sarah remained by the Hagar, and his son was thrown out of, or taken out of the promised land. The disciples are slaves of their teachers, as Saul was of Gamaliel. So after, you know, teaching them, they are told to go away. So if a son frees you, then you will truly be free. Free you in Holy Spirit. I know that you are descendants of Abraham, but you are trying to kill me because my word has no room among you. Remember that Abraham honored Melchizedek, who was a sadhu, and he honored his word and everything. And here you are, they wanted to kill him, who came in the name of Melchizedek, as our royal high priest. I tell you what I see, have seen in the Father's presence. Then do what you have heard from the Father Abraham. That's what they answered and said to him, our father is Abraham. Jesus said to them, if you were Abraham's children, you would be doing the works of Abraham, as the Samaritans were doing, in the name of their patriarch Joseph, to whom your elders sold as a slave to Egyptian. When he was sold as a slave to Egyptian, he was the only one who was faithful to Abraham, faithful to Yahweh. So they were getting small rain and eating food. But as soon as they threw him out, they became unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh. So Yahweh is jealous and revengeful God, not like our Elohim, who is loving and merciful. So Yahweh stopped rain. He is a God of nature. So he stopped rain and the land became barren. So they had to leave. Abraham is the father of the faithful, not of the unfaithful. Today they are the Jews of the outwardly, unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh. They are getting bundled up in Israel for final burning. And you will see atomic war taking place on 14 May 2023, after 5 years after 2018. But now you are trying to kill me, as they wanted to kill Joseph, a man who has told you the truth that I heard from God. I just say God is inside you, and if you do the will of God, which is logical reasoning, then you are with him. Logical reasoning through logo. Logo is his word. Abraham did not do this. He told him that he honored Melchizedek. He was a sadhu. You are doing the works of your 11 forefathers, are they call patriarchs, who sold Joseph as a slave to the Egyptian. So they said to him, we are not illegitimate. We have one Father God. Jesus said, they said they have one Father God is Yahweh and not Elohim. Sorry, I put this. Father God Yahweh. Yahweh the Demiurge, the potter, and not the real God. Real one is the Elohim, which his soul comes from, make us living. Jesus said to them, if God were your father, you would love me, God Yahweh, you know. But your father, you would love me. Because Jesus was the son of Yahweh, the second Adam. His name was, Hebrew name was Yeshua, made of two words, Yah from Yahweh, and Shua or Shiva means the primal Adam. So Jesus was the first born of Yahweh, the second Adam. Mary was surrogate mother and Joseph foster father. For I came from God, Elohim, and am here. I did not come on my own, but He sent me. That means He, Elohim, sent me. Because this is the dark age of Christ. When the rabbis become crook and they start cheating people, then the honest people make hue and cry, which the rabbis call them sinners, because they would not attend this synagogues of Satan, and they did not get anything good from them, so they won't attend them. So they called them sinners. So they were the ones who were looking for Christ, and then our Father God sent one to look after them in the name of Christ Jesus. He was the Messiah.